All right, folks, we're here at Spirit Halloween. One opened here in St. Louis, Missouri. And as you know, Halloween is getting closer and closer and closer and closer. And whenever you start seeing a Spirits open, or you start seeing not just the Spirits, but you see Home Depot and Lowe's and all these people start putting out all their Halloween stuff, you know, it's getting close. And our haunted houses here in St. Louis are getting ready to open as well. We're already selling tickets. We're having a sale this year. It's 25% off most tickets if you buy them in August. You get those tickets at scarefest.fearticket.com. Now, we're going to be like covering the heck out of our haunted house this Halloween, making a lot of content. But in the meantime, we're going to visit every place in St. Louis that sells Halloween. We've already been to Johnny Brock's. We made a video of that place, which I have to say was pretty incredible. But today, for 2024, we're going to go into Spirits and see what's new. Okay? Now, I will say, don't forget the darkness. We have a retail store inside the darkness as well. And the first thing you're greeted by is their new wall of t-shirts. I can't hold my liquor. That's funny. Look at that. They've got some kind of licensing deal with Terrifier because they got Terrifier on their logo. Clown Cafe. Drop by the Clown Cafe. American Psycho. I don't remember seeing that one last year. Some of these I've seen already. I've seen them in Spencer's. Oh, look at that. They're mocking Norman Rockwell there with Leatherface. And, oh man, who is that? Picasso, maybe? I don't know. Mocking that with Michael Myers. Let's see. Let's see if we can see what's different from last year. They got a big Scream section. And here is the Scary Movie mask. I don't remember seeing that last year, but maybe. I don't know. I can tell you in our gift store at the Darkness, which is a lot different than Spirits for sure, because we have a lot of more horror memorabilia. And we have a few costumes, but not a ton. The Joker, of course, is always going to be popular. And there he is, the Joker. And you got more than one style of the Joker. But what I was going to say was the gift store at the Darkness is much, much different. And if you really like horror, then you would love our gift store because it's completely 180 from Spirits. A lot of collectibles. We're just gonna kind of mosey around, and we're gonna finish this video off with looking at all of the animatronics, because that's what everybody likes the best. And we're just kind of sort of walking up and down the aisles, you know. And of course, they always have kind of like an adult section. Wouldn't be Spirits without an adult section. And let's see, an astronaut helmet, look at that. I don't remember seeing that last year. That's kind of cool, actually. Western section. Every year they're always gonna have Western, they're gonna have Pirates. Now look at these flags to hang off of your house. You have Trick or Treat, which they're supposed to make a sequel, Scream, which they're making another one, and Derry, which is something they're doing. They're making a Return to Derry, I think a TV show. So we'll have to wait and see what happens with that. Look at this. You can get a taser. Let's see if it actually works. Oh yeah, it does. Look at that. Now I can say that would be a great prop for some vendor to make for the haunted house industry, is a taser. That would be funny. But you know, like I have to say, when you come to the Halloween, when you come to a Spirits or anything like that, you're going to see a lot of the same stuff you saw last year. Now, I don't know if I saw that. You got fingernails, you've got, you know, all kinds of jewelry. Now, that's a pretty cool, like, skirt. But you're going to see a lot of the same stuff. I mean, let's just call a spade a spade. And one of the problems, in my opinion, with retail is Hollywood has not been able to create any kind of new horror franchise. And that's something that, you know, you don't see or hear anybody else talk about, but it's an absolute fact. They have not been able to create a new Freddy Krueger, Michael Myers type of character. So you keep getting the same ones over and over and over and over again. And there's really only so much you can do with them before you've worn them out. And Hollywood has been doing nothing, in my opinion, but making sequels and trying to redig up the past. Probably the worst remake I've ever seen, or not a remake, but like some sort of sequel, was The Exorcist, directed by the same guy who did the three Halloween movies, and they were so awful. The first one was good. The second one and the third one was just complete garbage. Now this one's kind of cool. Look at that. Look at his mouth light up. That's pretty neat. The Exorcist sequel, or whatever you're calling it, which had a little cameo with Linda Blair, Disney's Haunted Mansion, was so awful. It was so bad. I mean, golly, I hope they don't do that again. And here's a Beetlejuice character and a Bobby Strings. There's a You a Bride. And then here's the character from Beetlejuice, the sandworm that goes in and out of the ground when he opens the door. And then, of course, over here you have a lot of lighting effects, which is kind of cool. You have fire and ice, shutter flashers, flame lights. You know, you could get all of these on Amazon.com, or you can come pick them up here. Let's see, what else is here? It seems like if when you look at it, there's a lot of space on the walls for more merchandise. So this is one of the earlier spirits. This is, I think, the only one open in the St. Louis area so far, so they're probably still stocking shelves. Look at this. This is like a record, an id record. I doubt you can play it, but there you have it. And then you got Jamie Lee Curtis and Michael Myers and Norman Rockwell style painting. Here's a Beetlejuice hand, and it is static, so no, it does not lean over and grab your hand, but that's pretty cool. But anyway, I will tell you that in St. Louis, the best place in town to get anything and everything Halloween would be the Johnny Brock's Dungeon on Jefferson and 44. I've literally told people it's like a tourist attraction, really. If you like Halloween, check that out. I think it's about 30 or 40,000 square feet, so it would be bigger than any spirits by far. And not only would it be bigger than any spirits, it would have pretty much everything. Now, the one thing about spirits, though, is they'll have stuff that no one else can buy because they get exclusives on some things. And so then other, like, smaller retailers cannot buy them. And you can see here they've got a whole bunch of skeletons. Now I want to do a video on how to take this skeleton and make it look really scary, because right now it looks fake, of course. Here's you some lace fishnet garter tights. Love it. Some wings, more of those. And of course, if you ever want to be a witch, you've got these and you've got these, which are perfect for any witch or any kind of Halloween, really, costume. Let's see, what else is here? Of course, you got your makeup and your blood and all the typical stuff. And then you've got these props here, which this is like the spirit logo right here. Then you got the trick-or-treat character, and you've got these dolls. Now, Trick-or-Treat Studios has ones that are literally 20,000 times better, but probably these are a lot cheaper. Let's see what this costs. $100. $100. It looks okay. I don't know. I would rather have the Trick or Treat Studio one, obviously. Here's a bunch of soap dishes. Very nice. Let's take a look. You got the Beetlejuice sign right there. Now over here is going to be your section of masks. So spirits will just be one of our stops that we will be uploading videos on our channel. We plan on going to Menards because they sell a lot of Halloween stuff. There's a lot of weapons. Now, I'll tell you what, this looks so realistic here that I think if you walked up on a cop with that, he would shoot you. But anyway, we plan on going to Menards, Lowe's, Home Depot. We plan on going to Party City. And you know what? We'll make another trip to Johnny Brock's. And I'll tell you another place that we'll go is the Darkness Gift Store when it's all done and set up. We'll do a video of that. And as I was saying, our gift store is much different. It's not a lot of this cheap, you know, retail stuff. It's more collector stuff. If you like horror, you would really like it. We have a lot of cool masks. We have a lot of collectibles, collectible games, horror socks. I mean, tons of mugs, like every kind of mug you can think of. Now I will tell you that if you're a big fan of Spirit, you got to come here not the day after they close, but 2 days after they close. Everything will be 50% off. Well, they got a lot of cool skeletons over here. Look at this. I don't remember seeing that last year. And look at that piranha. That's pretty cool. And a buzzard, a two-headed buzzard. And a turtle. Isn't that cute? Let's see. What else do we have? Right here we have the original Frankenstein. Now, they say they're going to make another one of these pillow clowns from outer space. I'll believe it when I see it. We got some inflatables, a hearse, the Spirit logo. And what do we got here on this last wall? We got some latex props. And they are $70 and they're animated. Look at that. He uncovers his eyes. And the dolls laugh uncontrollably. And then let's see. We have some gates, some tombstones for your front yard. I'm guessing this is some sort of animation. Let's see. It doesn't even work. Nope, doesn't work. Some lanterns for your front yard. Very nice. I love those creepy dolls. Check that out. Oh yeah, those are really cool. I like those. And basically everything else in here is going to be cheaper costumes. Everything in this section is going to be cheaper costumes. Look at that Transformer. You can be Bumblebee. That's cute. Now, of course, you're going to have Star Wars and a lot of Disney stuff, of course. And there's an armored Batman. Five Nights of Freddy. Fortnite. They're licensing the heck out of that, I see. More Scream stuff over here. You just can't get away from Scream. It just is what it is. And look at that knife. Nice. Alright, and as usual, this video is being made without any editing. It's very continuous. Now you can have Mario, you can have Ghostbusters. It's all right here. They have all the costumes. And they've got the... Now this is something we have at the Darkness, and we have a lot of them. Horror plushies for sale. We have tons of them. And Wednesday has been very popular thanks to the Netflix show. I actually did very much like the Wednesday show. I thought it was very good. Big fan. Big fan. And there's Disney's monsters. a stuffed dummy prop so you can put your own clothes on it. Let's see what's over here.
Hey, sir, how
you doing? Hello. Spider-Web. Oh, yeah. Spider-Webs. Trick-or-treat stuff. Pumpkin carving. It's all here. More plushies. Now, this is a cool plushie right here. Michael Myers. I haven't seen this one before. He's really cool. And he's got that big old knife. And you have E.T. And then, what the heck is his name? I can't remember. It's from Nightmare Before Christmas. And I love this movie right here. Corpse's Bride. Lots of cool stuff here. And we're going to get to the animations here in a second. They have Pops. Nightmare Before Christmas. No, there is no Nightmare. It's Trick or Treat. And some kind of version of a clown. You have earrings. Now look, they got a bunch of horror socks here. Very nice. They got some board games. A Scooby-Doo, Monopoly. A Wednesday Ouija board. Here's your keychains. We sell these at the Darkness Gift Store as well. I always like this section right here because there's a lot of cool stuff in here. Magnets, stickers. And over here you got eyeballs. Now I can tell you at the haunted house, we've had actors in our queue lines and we stock up on this kind of stuff and they give them out to people. You got teeth. And here's your, these candies are really good, by the way. And then you have mugs. And then, let's go over and see the animatronics. Because that's what everybody wants to see anyway. The first one you come to is Scream. Let's see what he does.
Strange that you and I have never spoken on the phone. This is long overdue.
Now, one of the things you'll notice is his knife is pointing up. And so I'm assuming that was done for safety reasons, so he doesn't stab somebody. And then you've got something they're calling the Ringmaster.
To the carnival. My friends are going to show you a scary good time.
It looks like he's got lights in his stomach. Yeah, so he would look cooler at night, obviously. He's got some sort of projector. Yeah, in his stomach. That's really cool. I like that. So it says, welcome to the carnival. And of course you have Michael Myers over here. You got Friday the 13th. You've got Chucky. All those staples are over here. Now let's walk over to these animations. You've got a death wheel that you spin. Sorry, now you're dead inside. So they sell a wheel. And then you have this clown. Let's step on it and see. His head spins around and he's got bowling pins. Nice. Okay, now you have a Zoltar of some kind. That looks really cool right there. I guess it's a photo op. So you're supposed to go in from behind maybe? That would be my guess. Is that you come in here and it's a photo op. I'm guessing. I don't know. And here is a Terrifier. So I'm pressing the button. And he's waving at me. Nice. And it's saying that you can buy blood, you know, and put it all on him. And then look at this popcorn prop. Now that is cool, I have to tell you. And Art the Clown is $199. Okay, so if we come around here, we have another, we have a scarecrow. So he doesn't do a whole lot. And then you got, I guess this is like Slender Man. Look at it, he's got lights in his stomach. And he just kind of moves around. And then you have this other skeleton. You press the button. And look at this. It's like a press the yellow button on the handle to activate. I pressed and the scarecrow doesn't work. But look at all the duck targets and everything. Now that is really cool. See how they're kind of going around in circles? I don't know if you can buy those, but that one's cool. So you reach in to get the candy and the scarecrow scares you. And he is $109. Moving right along. Watch out. Okay, nothing happens there. And there's you a really cool rat and some more popcorn. And here's Wanda Webworth, $269. That looks pretty cool. And I like their ticket sign. And that marquee up there is pretty nice as well. Okay, now we've got this popcorn. That's funny.
We've added some new ingredients.
And it says it's our fun house. Oh, so it pops up. And there's a dead guy in there. And then there's like a little mini haunted house you can walk through. And it's just got video effects on the wall. And these are really nice fun house. And now you've got this bear. And he's balancing himself on the ball. And he's $279. And then you have this spider that leaps up. And then here it tells you all the extra prices. You have a rat, popcorn, zombie seagull. So everything ranges from $5 to $50. And so they're actually selling these risers and everything so you can set them up like probably for your home haunt. And then this is the last animation right here.
Katie, Haiti, everyone. Want to hear a song? Let me sing it for you. Oh, I know a naughty child who was so very bad. He ate up all my candy and made me real mad. So when I get free, I'm gonna fix him good. He's gonna bump heads with this block of wood. Let that be a lesson, kids. Don't be a blockhead.
And this is called Bobby Strings. He's $309. And you can see you can have one right there. And there's a man-possessed friend dog, a ghost. And that pretty much is Spirits for 2024. We have many more places to go see. And Halloween is right around the corner. And haunted houses will be opening up all over the country. You can find them at hauntworld.com, and we encourage you to go there and find a haunted house near you. And we look forward to the Halloween season, especially for our haunted houses. And you can learn more about our haunted houses at scarefest.com. And follow us on Instagram at scarefest or TikTok at darkest haunted house. But either way, this is the first video that we're making of many about Halloween happenings in and around St. Louis, which also relate to the rest of the country, right? Because we got pretty much the same things opening here as everywhere else. And so we're gonna try to cover them all, everything. And we're also gonna be visiting a lot of haunted houses around the country. That's another thing we're gonna be doing. Now we'll tell you at our gift store, anything Jeepers Creepers sells. And they got Deadpool up there. And Madame Leota, nice. Look at that, they sell a little turtle shell and all the turtle masks, a little turtle shell. Well, at any rate, folks, that's gonna be about it from Spirit. We hope you liked the little tour. I wouldn't say that anything was earth shattering, okay? It is what it is. It's Halloween. And there's a lot of cool stuff to buy and decorate your house. And that's what I really love, that home haunting has literally exploded. And you have to thank companies like Spirit, Home Depot, Lowe's, Menards, and even the other company, Party City, does their own animations as well. All these people are doing animations now. It's really crazy. But if you want to see the best animations in the world, come to a haunted house near you. You'll see some pretty insane stuff. Now, as we head out, I have to say, this is a pretty cool costume right here. I really like that. And you could become a pumpkin. It's very nice. These you could actually use in a real haunted house too, because they're just scary, I think. And look at all these costumes. Now, I will tell you, there is a massive difference between the costumes that are purchased here at a retail store from the ones and masks, from the ones and makeup, from the ones you would use in a professional haunted house. I literally have spent well over $100,000 on masks. I've spent well over, you know, a couple hundred thousand dollars on costumes, probably a couple hundred thousand on masks. And every year I have to spend $25,000, $30,000 on makeup equipment. And that's the difference. I don't buy makeup here. We have to buy professional makeup because, you know, it gets hot and it sweats off. So you have to get like some really good stuff. So I don't think we've missed anything, but I will say here's Freddy Krueger and they have collector gloves. That's nice. And Nightmare Before Christmas. And the new Beetlejuice movie is coming out. I can't wait for that. Now, I didn't see this before. That is really nice. See that plastic Michael Myers mask? That looks really good. Well, that about does it, folks. Now, here's one thing that's interesting. They tell you that they have many more animatronics at spirithalloween.com. Emily, Victor, Art the Clown. Way more animations are online. So you just come here and scan that barcode and you can buy all the animations you want. So, with that being said, have a great Halloween. And I will say Halloween has officially started. It is official that Halloween has started. Now, you know, the more you look, the more you're going to see something cool. And by the way, that is cool right there. Garfield the Cat. You know, we built a Garfield the Cat dark ride many years ago. All right. Well, that's it from Halloween Superstore. Until next time, make sure you like and subscribe. And we will see you very, very soon with more Halloween happenings.